In 2011, America barred Chinese astronauts from the International Space Station. This decision set in motion a series of events that have come to haunt them 12 years later. In 2022, China inaugurated their own celestial abode, the Tiangong space station, and with the ISS set to retire in 2031, after having served for 3 decades, the Chinese space station could well and good be the only one in the years to come. But why is the exploration of space even important? What is the end goal? What are the visions that drive China's space strategy? And what exactly does the cosmic future hold for all of us? Before we dive into these questions, please don't forget to support us by liking this video and subscribing to our channel. We appreciate it more than you know. Now let's dive right in. The exploration and study of space is important for a number of reasons, of which I'll be focusing on 4. The expansion of scientific knowledge, the birth of technological innovation, untapped economic opportunities, and national security. For starters, space exploration has significantly augmented our understanding of the cosmos. Take the Hubble Space Telescope, for example. Launched in 1990, it has shed light on captivating subjects ranging from the complex mechanisms behind the formation of galaxies to the life cycles of stars and even the enigmatic essence of dark matter. But beyond just allowing us to understand our universe, space exploration has also been the catalyst for cutting-edge technological advancements that have seeped into modern life right here on Earth. Did you know that solar panels were initially created for spacecraft and that GPS systems and satellite-driven weather forecasts are also offshoots of space technology? And it doesn't just stop there. Space technology has also accelerated advancements in medicine, allowing us, among other things, to introduce better radiation shielding and more sophisticated life support systems. NASA's efforts to reduce bone density loss in astronauts due to microgravity has also furthered the development of osteoporosis treatments. Another important factor is that space exploration is also closely intertwined with national security. Satellites have now become integral for communication, navigation, and reconnaissance missions. Advancements in space exploration can arm countries with advanced weaponry and technologies crucial for safeguarding national interests. Lastly, and perhaps not obviously, space exploration also opens up business opportunities. It helps create jobs in the aerospace sector and bolsters economies. Companies like Richard Branson's Virgin Galactic and Elon Musk's SpaceX are also working on space tourism. Concepts like asteroid mining might seem plucked from a sci-fi novel, but they might soon present genuine avenues for resource extraction. Given the potential that space presents, is it any wonder why the world's leading countries seem to be in a tug of war with each other over who will conquer it first? This so-called war first began in 1957 when the USSR launched Sputnik, the first artificial satellite. America then launched NASA in 1958, while the USSR followed up by sending a man named Yuri Gagarin to space in 1961 for a 15-minute flight. 3 weeks later, the US also achieved this feat, and thus began the battle to see who would be the first to land on the moon. As it turns out, it was NASA that emerged victorious in 1969 with its Apollo 2 mission. The USSR, on the other hand, made 4 attempts at a moon landing between 69 and 72, but failed all 4 times. Eventually, the emphasis in space exploration began to shift towards space stations as scientists became increasingly interested in delving deeper into the mysteries of the cosmos, understanding stars, planets, asteroids, and the like. In 1971, the Soviets launched the world's first space station, which was later followed by NASA's Skylab. In 1984, US President Ronald Reagan commissioned NASA to establish the International Space Station, recognizing the need for a collaborative global platform for advanced research. 5 space agencies from the US, Russia, Japan, Canada, and Europe collaborated to operate it, and its assembly began in 1998, while the first crew was sent in 2000. Upon its inception, the ISS was a collaborative effort involving 15 countries, and that number has since grown. However, surprise, surprise, notably absent from this international cooperation are Chinese astronauts who were barred from setting foot on the ISS due to a 2011 US congressional law, which, citing national security concerns, prohibits any direct engagement between American and Chinese astronauts. Reports suggest that America's apprehensions are rooted in fears of IP theft by the Chinese government. China, however, didn't let the ban hold it back and became the 3rd country to send an individual to space in spite of it. It also began to race ahead to develop its own space station known as Tiangong or the Heavenly Dream. And in September 2011, China launched its first module, Tiangong 1, thus beginning a space war with the US. In November 2011, China followed up by successfully docking an uncrewed spacecraft called Shenzhou 8 to Tiangong 1, followed by a crewed spacecraft, Shenzhou 9, in 2012. Progress continued, and in 2016, the Chinese launched Tiangong 2, the 2nd module of China's space station, followed by the addition of two science labs, Wenchuan and Mengjian, in 2022. In the same year, China, truly on a roll, released a five-year plan regarding their space venture. The plan includes moon landings, strengthening China's space infrastructure, and at least 1,000 space experiments. In May 2023, there were six researchers in the Chinese space station studying the surface of the moon. China landed its first moon rover in 2019 and has plans to land two more in the coming 5 years. China also aims to explore other objects in our solar system and plans to send rovers to asteroids near Earth and spacecraft to Jupiter and Uranus. Collaboration with Russia to construct a lunar space station is also on the cards. Among other things, China is also aiming to perform medical experiments at its space station, including determining how humans respond to radiation in space and what impact this radiation has on our DNA. Other experiments that they're planning include the behavior of fluids and matter and research around whether or not it is possible for humanity to colonize space. Who knows, in a few years, I might be recording a video for this channel from Mars if they'll take me. By 2024, China will also launch their space station telescope known as Shentian to aid Chinese scientists in their futuristic space research. The telescope will reportedly be able to cover 40% of the sky in merely 10 years and will be armed with a 2.5 billion pixel camera to ensure impeccable clarity. It'll be used to observe UV and visible rays in space and to study dark matter and energy. China is undeniably making progress in space, but America isn't just sitting back and doing nothing about it. With both NASA and SpaceX leading the charge, the race for dominance is on. NASA's Artemis program is set to beat China back to the moon, and they mean business. Artemis 1 was a stellar success, orbiting the moon with an uncrewed spacecraft in December 2022, and that was just the beginning. Artemis 2, which is scheduled for November 2024, will have a crew of four daring astronauts, while Artemis 3 will make an attempt to land near the moon's south pole on a SpaceX Starship. The Artemis program also involves building a space station around the moon known as the Lunar Orbital Platform Gateway. The moon landing, of course, is not NASA's main objective. They only want to use it as a learning opportunity for when they attempt to land on Mars. The Artemis program is like a practice run for colonization plans, building momentum towards a human settlement on the red planet. Even Elon Musk, the mastermind behind SpaceX, is in on the action. Teaming up with NASA for their Mars program, he's boldly claiming that he'll land a human on Mars by 2029. While China has made progress, it nevertheless is still lagging far behind America in outer space. One indicator of this is the cost of China's commercial space programs. While China claims that it is open to collaboration with other countries in order to become a dominant player in space, the reality is that China's space program is heavily politicized and may drive other countries away. The launch areas, control centers, and most sites are run by the Chinese military, and the astronauts that China sends into space are also military personnel. So where exactly does this leave us on the US versus China space war? Who's more likely to come out on top? While China's space achievements are definitely commendable, let's face it, they still have a lot of ground to cover before they can match America's extensive experience and research capabilities in the cosmos. Nevertheless, if China keeps charging ahead with the same enthusiasm and dedication, they just might surprise the world and rise to the top of the celestial ladder. The space race is far from over, and the excitement of what's to come is enough to keep us all on the edge of our seats.